press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Good morning, everybody. So in our last class, we discussed neural control and coordination. In this class, we'll discuss chemical coordination and integration. Okay. So we know that to maintain homeostasis in an organism, as Nitin, Veena, Amsashri, Nishan, Siddesh, everyone, good morning. So, to maintain homeostasis in an organism, there is a need to coordinate functions of different organs in an organism. So, neural system is going to do this function. As the nerves cannot innervate all the cells in our body, there is a need of other system to innervate or to bring coordination among the functions of different organs in an organism or in a body. So that is done by endocrine system. So neural system and endocrine system together brings coordination and also integration between different functions of different organs in an organism to maintain a homeostasis in an organism. So then what is endocrine system? So, before going to the endocrine system, we discuss about difference between exocrine gland and endocrine gland. So, as we know that in your lower classes, exocrine glands have ducts to release their secretions to a target area where the function of that secretion is needed. Whereas in endocrine gland, they don't have any ducts to release their secretion. That's why they release their secretion into blood. From the blood, it reaches different organs or to the target area where the hormone function is needed. So endocrine glands are ductless glands. That's why they release their secretion into blood. Through the blood, these secretion reach target organs or tissues to bring their function. So then what the secretions of endocrine glands are called? Hormones. Secretions of endocrine glands are called hormones. Then what are hormones? Hormones are chemical substances. They are non-nutrient chemical substances. See here, hormones are non-nutrient chemical substances produced in very trace amount, and they act as a intercellular messengers. Hormones are non-nutrient chemical substances which act as a intercellular messengers. Non-nutrient antandre, they will not provide us any ATP molecule, they will not provide us any energy. Understood? That's why they are non-nutrient. Whereas carbohydrate, proteins, lipids, they provide us energy. But these chemicals or these will not provide us any type of energy. That's why they are non-nutrient chemical substances. Act as a intercellular messenger. Intercellular message means they helps to transfer message from one cell to another cell. And they are produced in very trace amount or very little amount. That is the definition of hormones. Hormones are non-nutrient chemical substances which act as intercellular messengers and produced in very trace amount. So the endocrine system comprises of endocrine gland and other tissues present in different parts of our body which produces hormones. So, coming to the different types of endocrine gland, we have pituitary gland, pineal gland, adrenal gland, thyroid, parathyroid, pancreas. Like this, we have many types of endocrine glands. So, hypothalamus is also called master gland. That means we know that pituitary gland, which is present in cella tarsica in skull, it's a bony socket called cella tarsica. So there we see the situation of where the pituitary gland is present. And this pituitary gland is linked to hypothalamus through a stalk called infundibulum. It's called infundibulum. Understood? So this hypothalamus, which is called as master of master gland, because pituitary gland is considered as master gland because it controls functions of the other endocrine glands. And this pituitary is controlled by hypothalamus. That's why hypothalamus is called master of master gland, whereas pituitary gland is called master of endocrine glands. This hypothalamus also releases hormones, two types of hormones. One is releasing hormones, another one is inhibiting hormone. Releasing hormone and inhibiting hormone. So this hypothalamus, which produces releasing and inhibiting hormone, we have gonadotropic releasing hormones. In that we have FSH and LH. So gonadotropic releasing hormone acts on anterior pituitary gland and initiates the release of FSH and LH. Whereas inhibiting hormone released by hypothalamus in acts on pituitary gland and inhibits the release of somatostatin hormone. Inhibits the release of somatostatin hormone. Gonadotropic releasing hormone released by hypothalamus stimulates anterior pituitary gland to release follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. Adheriti, inhibiting hormone released by hypothalamus stops or prevents the release of somatostatin from the pituitary gland. So it prevents the release of somatostatin. So these functions will discuss under anterior pituitary gland. So this pituitary gland is also called hypophysis, and secretin is the first hormone discovered by Bayliss and Starling. Pituitary gland is divided anatomically, it is divided into two parts, adenohypophysis and neurohypophysis. Pituitary gland is divided into adenohypophysis. Adeno, and it's adenohypophysis is anterior pituitary gland. Neurohypophysis is posterior pituitary gland. So again, adenohypophysis is divided into pars distalis and pars intermedia, and posterior is called pars nervosa. So together, pars distalis and pars intermedia, together it is called anterior pituitary gland. And posterior is called pars nervosa. Pars distalis produces hormones called growth hormone, prolactin hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, then it stimulates adrenocorticotropic hormone. Pars intermedia releases melanocyte stimulating hormone, and pars nervosa releases oxytocin and vasopressin. So totally 9 hormones are released by pituitary gland: growth hormone, prolactin hormone, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone, and from pars intermedia, melanocyte stimulating hormone, and pars nervosa, we see oxytocin and vasopressin. So here, the hypothalamic neurons produces hormones and they regulate the function of pituitary gland. Some of the hormones released by the hypothalamic neurons will release to the circulatory system. That means they release to the blood and then it reaches anterior pituitary gland. So between the hypothalamic hormones and anterior pituitary gland, the hormones reach through portal circulatory system. But in posterior pituitary gland, we see the direct connection between hypothalamus and posterior pituitary gland. The hormones are released directly into the posterior pituitary gland. That's why it's called pars nervosa. So coming to the individual hormones now, growth hormone. So growth hormone as the name indicates, it helps in the development of an organism. So the growth hormone also increases blood glucose level in an organism. The hyper secretion of growth hormone results in gigantism due to hyper secretion of, whereas hyposecretion results in pituitary dwarfism. So ee points ella nevu competitive ge nenpitkobeku. So growth hormone, you know that growth, it helps in growth of an organism. When the hormone increase is more, when the hormone synthesis is more, it results in a condition called gigantism. And then tumba udda belitara. So when hypo means less secretion of hormone, results in stunted growth. And tumba kullak irthara, it's called pituitary dwarfism. Understood? It is about growth hormone. Next, prolactin hormone. Prolactin hormone is also called mammotropic hormone or lactogenic hormone. This prolactin hormone acts on mammary gland. It acts on mammary gland in female. The function of prolactin is seen in female, where it acts on mammary gland. It helps in differentiation of mammary cells in mammary gland and also helps in secretion of milk. That's why it is also called lactogenic hormone. So this prolactin hormone, the function is seen in female. Mainly it helps in differentiation of mammary gland and also helps in secretion of milk during lactation period to feed their young ones or to nourish their young ones. It is about prolactin hormone. So the next hormone we have, follicle stimulating hormone. So this follicle stimulating hormone, so they are called gonadotropic hormones, since they act on gonads, that is they act on ovary and also testes. In female, FSH acts on ovary. In male, it acts on testes. FSH, this is ovary. So nodi idu uterus and polyuterethal fever. Female reproductive system diagram makidira. So that pair of ovary is present on either side of the uterus. So this ovary, so this FSH acts on differentiation of follicles, and primary follicle idide enagutte mature Graafian follicle agutte. So in primary follicle will become mature Graafian follicle with the help of hormone follicle stimulating hormone. So ivage enagutte, while the growth primary follicle ididu mature Graafian follicle aguvaga, so these follicles releases one hormone called estrogen. Follicles releases hormone called estrogen that is mainly responsible for the development of female secondary sexual characters. So, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟಿಮ್ಯುಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಯಾವ್ದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ? ಓವರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೆಚುರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್. ದ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಮೆಚೂರ್ ಗ್ರಾಫಿಯನ್ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದ ಓವಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಷನ್ ದ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಟರ್ಷರಿ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಇಸ್ಟ್ರೋಜನ್. ದಟ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ characters. So ovary also acts as an endocrine gland because it secretes a hormone estrogen, and also it secretes another hormone called progesterone. We'll discuss later. In testes, follicles. So we pair of testes are present in a scrotum. So these testes contain, when we take sections, they contain seminiferous tubules. These are seminiferous tubules. Between seminiferous, so these are seminiferous tubules. So these follicles acts on seminiferous tubules and helps in spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis and then production of sperms. So follicle stimulating hormone acts on ovary, helps in maturation of primary follicle into mature graafian follicle. Same follicle stimulating hormone in testes acts on seminiferous tubules and helps in spermatogenesis. So this FSH and LH are called gonadotropins because they act on gonads. Ovary matha testes mela act madutte. So that is about FSH. Coming to the LH, luteinizing hormone. This luteinizing hormone acts on mature graafian follicle and helps in rupture of that follicle. This mature graafian follicle alle irutte ovum irutte. So ovum fallopian tube ge hogbekandre the graafian follicle should be ruptured. So the ruptured is mainly due to the LH hormone. When LH acts on mature graafian follicle, the ovum from the ovary will be released to the fallopian tube. Understood? After the rupture, the graafian follicle will become corpus luteum. It becomes corpus luteum. This corpus luteum produces a hormone called progesterone. This progesterone helps to maintain endometrium in a uterus. ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯೂಟ್ರಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ತಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಓವಮ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸ್ ಆಗಿ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್. ಇಂಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಯೂಟ್ರಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಆ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಬೇಕು, ಥಿಕ್ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಥಿಕ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಬೈ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಸ್ಟಿರಾನ್. ಯುಟಿಲೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಮೆಚೂರ್ ಗ್ರಾಫಿಯನ್ ಫಾಲಿಕಲ್. That results in rupture of the follicle. Avaga a mature graafian follicle ira ovum ellig release agutte, fallopian tube release agutte. Then that ruptured graafian follicle will become corpus luteum and produces a hormone called progesterone. Illi nan estrogen hormone helde, estrogen helps to produce endometrium, whereas progesterone helps to maintain thickness of ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ. ಆ ಥಿಕ್ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ಬೇಕು ನಮಗೆ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಇಂಪ್ಲಾಂಟೇಶನ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಓವಮ್ ಆರ್ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಥಿಕ್ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಓವರಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಂಡೋಕ್ರೈನ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಬೈ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಎಂಡೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಯಂ ಥಿಕ್ನೆಸ್, it is called pregnancy maintaining hormone. Endometrium thick illa andre abortions agutte. Hagage endometrium tumba thick irbek, tumba alla, so 14 to 15 millimeter thickness should be there. So below 10 implantation agala. That's why progesterone is called pregnancy maintaining hormone. So in detail we'll discuss this in your human reproduction chapter. ಹಾಗೇನೆ ಲ್ಯುಟಿನೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನು ಟೆಸ್ಟೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ it acts on Leydig cells or interstitial cells. Interstitial cells. Follicles madhya group of cells are called Leydig cells or interstitial cells. This LH acts on interstitial cells. Hagagi, this LH in male is called interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Idu LH in male, only in males it is called interstitial. Ekane adu yadun stimulate martide. Interstitial cells na stimulate martide. Interstitial cell stimulating hormone to secrete androgen called testosterone. So it helps in the secretion of androgen called testosterone, which is responsible for spermatogenesis in male and also responsible for development of male secondary sexual characters. So that is the function of luteinizing hormone in female and in male. So next we'll move on to thyroid stimulating hormone. So, thyroid stimulating hormone acts on thyroid gland. Thyroid stimulating hormone acts on thyroid gland and really in thyroid gland we see follicles and stromal cells. So, from the follicles, there is release of triiodothyronine and tetraiodothyronine. Tetraiodothyronine are also called thyroxine. So, T3 and T4, triiodothyronine and tetraiodothyronine are released by follicles. From stromal cells, we see release of thyrocalcitonin. That is TCT. So these hormones T3 and T4 are very much needed for normal functions of an organism. They control basal metabolic rate. That means they have their role in their metabolism of carbohydrate, proteins and lipids. So this synthesis of hormones requires iodine. Iodine is very important in the synthesis of thyroid hormones. Deficiency of iodine results in a condition called goiter. Enlargement of thyroid gland, which is the thyroid gland is present in front of the trachea. So we have two lobes of thyroid gland which is linked with like this isthmus. Here we see a joining area called isthmus. So when the thyroid gland increases, enlargement of thyroid gland is called goiter, due to deficiency of iodine. So during that condition, thyroid deficiency results in mainly during pregnancy, it results in underdevelopment of developing embryo or stunted growth, mental retardation, low intelligent quotient. So all these results when there is deficiency of thyroid hormones during pregnancy. So that condition is called cretinism. In case of cancer, thyroid cancer cell, that time we see hypersecretion of thyroid hormones. Hyper means more secretion of thyroid hormones results in the hypersecretion of thyroid hormones affects the physiology of a organisms. So that is about thyroid hormones. And one more, the stromal cells which releases thyrocalcitonin, it decreases blood calcium level. Thyrocalcitonin decreases blood calcium level. So it helps the bone to take up calcium, thereby calcium level in the blood is going to be decreased. So thyroid gland produces T3, T4 and thyrocalcitonin. So these hormones helps to maintain. They bring basal. They are very important for basal metabolic rate in an organism. Whereas thyrocalcitonin, TCT, helps to decrease blood calcium level. So one more hormone is there, that is parathyroid. Parathyroid gland produces a hormone called parathyroid hormone. So parathyroid gland, the four parathyroid glands are there, which are present back of the thyroid gland. So this parathyroid gland produces hormone, parathyroid hormone, which increases calcium level in blood. Increases calcium level in blood. So thyrocalcitonin en maartta ide, decreases calcium level in blood. Blood lalli calcium level kammi aayitu andre, we need calcium for muscular contraction. Calcium illana muscle contraction agala. So we need calcium. So during that condition, parathyroid gland helps to release calcium from the bone. Resorption of bone results in release of calcium in the blood. That's why it increases calcium level in blood. So these two hormones, parathyroid hormone and thyrocalcitonin, are antagonist in nature. Antagonist antandre eno, thyrocalcitonin calcium level decrease maartta ide, parathyroid en maartta ide, increase maartta ide. These two hormone functions are opposite in nature. That's why antagonistic hormones anta heltivi. So these two hormones helps to maintain blood calcium level in an organism. It is about parathyroid gland. Then coming to the adrenocorticotropic hormone. ACTH means adrenocorticotropic hormone. So above the kidney we see the triangular shape adrenal gland is having divided into adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. Adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. This adrenal medulla is not under the control of pituitary gland. It is competitively nenpitkobek. Whereas adrenal cortex is under the control of pituitary gland, but adrenal medulla is not under the control of pituitary gland. Adrenal medulla produces a hormone called adrenaline and noradrenaline. They are also called epinephrine and norepinephrine. Together they are called catecholamines. Together they are called catecholamines. So these hormones, catecholamines, are called emergency hormones. Enikke emergency hormones antivi andre, these hormones are given to patient when they in a very serious condition, at the last moment, when we see the heart rate and respiratory rate decreasing tumba low iddaga, ee hormones na inject martivi so that the respiratory rate and heart rate is going to be increased. That's why these hormones are called emergency hormones or fight or flight hormones. Fight or flight hormones. Why these hormones are called fight or flight hormones? Because these hormones are given to patient in emergency conditions when their heart rate and respiratory rate are very low. Because these hormones increases heart rate and respiratory rate. And also this catecholamine increases blood glucose level. It increases blood glucose level. That is about adrenal medulla. So adrenal cortex is having three layers: outer layer, middle layer and inner layer. So outer is zona glomerulosa, middle is zona fasciculata, and inner is zona reticulata. Outer is zona glomerulosa, middle is zona fasciculata, and inner is zona reticularis. So these hormones which are produced by all these three layers are called corticoids. They are called adrenal cortex hormones are called corticoids. The corticoids which act on carbohydrate metabolism, are called glucocorticoids. Glucose andre eno? Carbohydrate. So the corticoids which act on carbohydrate metabolism are called glucocorticoids, and corticoids which helps in the maintaining water and electrolyte balance in our body are called mineralocorticoids. Example for mineralocorticoids is aldosterone. Corticoids which helps to maintain water and electrolyte balance in our body are called mineralocorticoids. Example is aldosterone. Aldosterone is a mineralocorticoid. This is also a competitive question. So that is about adrenal gland. Adrenocorticotropic hormone acts on adrenal cortex. And hormones released by adrenal cortex are called corticoids. The corticoids which act on carbohydrate metabolism are called glucocorticoids, and the corticoids which helps to maintain water and electrolyte balance are called mineralocorticoids. Example for mineralocorticoid is aldosterone. So this is about the adrenal hormones. Next, coming to the melanocyte stimulating hormone. This melanocyte stimulating hormone, MSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone, acts on melanocytes. That means melanin containing cells. The cells which contain pigment called melanin are called melanocytes. On that cells, MSH is going to act and responsible for skin pigmentation. That is melanocyte stimulating hormone. So the two hormones are produced by pars nervosa or posterior pituitary gland. So otherly, oxytocin. Oxytocin is a hormone released by posterior pituitary gland which acts on uterine muscles, So this is a fetus. So this oxytocin acts on myometrium, middle layer of the uterus. So in middle layer mele oxytocin act madutha during parturition, during childbirth, delivery time ali, and induces vigorous or strong uterine contraction. Continuous agi contract madadage enagutte, the fetus will come out and parturition is going to occur. Oxytocin acts on middle layer or myometrium of the uterus and constrict madadage enagutte, uterine muscles constrict adage, a developed fetus enagutte, it will be pushed out of the vagina. That results in child birth. So that's why oxytocin is also called birth hormone. Yake idhen madutte, developed fetus iruvanta uterus, middle layer of uterus en madutte, strong contraction madutte, that contraction pushes the developed fetus out of the vagina and results in childbirth. And also this oxytocin helps in ejection of milk, mammary gland into the mouth of the baby, milk has to be released. The release of milk is done by oxytocin. Oxytocin helps in ejection of milk. Oxytocin helps in ejection of milk, and also it helps in childbirth by strong uterine contraction during parturition. So that is about oxytocin. The next hormone is vasopressin. Vasopressin is also called antidiuretic hormone, ADH, antidiuretic hormone. This hormone acts on distal, this is PCT, this is distal convoluted tubules and collecting ducts. So this vasopressin acts on DCT, distal convoluted tubules, and helps in reabsorption of water and electrolytes. Thereby prevents diuresis. Diuresis andre eno? Loss of water through the urine. Loss of water through the urine is called diuresis. That diuresis is prevented by the ADH by absorbing water from the DCT. That's why it is also called antidiuretic hormone. That means it prevents diuresis. Vasopressin acts on distal convoluted tubule of nephron and reabsorbs the water and electrolytes. That's why, as it prevents diuresis, it is called antidiuretic hormone. So this is about the hormones of pituitary gland. We'll discuss some hormones released by other than pituitary gland. So pineal gland, it is present in forebrain. It produces a hormone called melatonin. The peptide hormone called melatonin, which is responsible for 24-hour rhythm of an organ. That means sleep and wake cycle. Sleep and wake cycle in an organism is maintained by melatonin. With that, it also helps in basal metabolic rate. So melatonin is a hormone produced by pineal gland, mainly responsible for 24-hour rhythm of an organism. That means sleep and wake cycle. So in presence of light, melatonin secretion is more. That time we are not able to sleep. In the absence of light, the secretion stops and will go to sleep. In this way, melatonin mainly helps sleep and wake cycle in an organism. So the other gland is pancreas. It is a composite gland or heterocrine gland. Hetero means mix. It acts as both exocrine gland and endocrine gland. Exocrine gland of pancreas produces enzymes. Endocrine gland of pancreas is called highlights of Langerhans, which produces, they have two types of cells, alpha cells and beta cells. Highlights of Langerhans have, one more is delta cell is also there, but for you, these two are important. So delta cell secretes somatostatin. These two are very important. Alpha cell secretes a hormone called glucagon. And beta cell secretes a hormone called insulin. This glucagon acts on glycogen. Glucagon acts on glycogen and converts that into glucose. Whereas insulin acts on glucose and converts that into glycogen. Glucagon acts on glycogen, glycogenolysis, breaking of glycogen results in glucose. blood glucose level ay nagar jaasti agutte hagagi glucagon is called hyperglycemic hormone it is called hyperglycemic hormone insulin en maartta ide blood alli iro glucose na glycogen ig convert madutte which is stored in liver and muscles so insulin en maartide blood glucose level na कमी मारता है दे दैट्स व्हाई इंसुलिन इज अ हाइपोग्लाइसेमिक हार्मोन सो कॉम्पिटेटिव ನೆನಪಿಟ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ग्लूकोगन इज अ हाइपरग्लाइसेमिक ब्लड ग्लूकोज लेवल ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಬೈ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ಲೈಕೋಜನ್ ಇಂಟು ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದೆ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಗ್ಲೈಕೋಜನ್ ಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಹೈಪೋಗ್ಲೈಸೆಮಿಕ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ Deficiency of insulin results in a condition called metabolic disorder called diabetes mellitus. So insulin deficiency results in a metabolic disorder called diabetes mellitus. So that is about pancreas and hormones released by other than the endocrine glands like heart also releases hormone kidney also releases hormone and gastrointestinal tract also releases hormone heart releases a hormone called atrial natriuretic factor kidney releases hormone called erythropoietin gastrointestinal tract releases hormone called CCK cholecystokinin secretin gastric inhibitory peptide and gastric hormones so atrial natriuretic factor main function is to decrease blood pressure idana navu excretory system alli how this helps to decrease blood glucose blood pressure anta avaga na in detail we'll discuss that erythropoietin helps in the formation or synthesis of rbcs they help in the synthesis of rbcs cck acts on liver and pancreas it acts on liver and pancreas on liver it helps to produce bile juice on pancreas it helps to produce pancreatic enzymes so the all competitive question CCK cholecystokinin acts on liver and produces bile juice secretin acts on pancreas sorry cholecystokinin acts on pancreas and produces pancreatic enzymes even secretin acts only on pancreas and helps to release water and bicarbonate ions gastric inhibitory peptide inhibits the release of gastrin hormone acts on gastric glands and helps to release hydrochloric acid and pepsinogen so gastrin hormone acts on gastric glands and helps to release HCl hydrochloric acid and pepsinogen so this gastric inhibitory peptide prevents the release of gastrin hormone so these are the hormones produced by other than endocrine glands then classification of hormones are there based on their chemical nature protein hormones based on chemical nature hormones are classified into protein hormones steroid hormones iodine hormones like that so protein hormones are insulin glucagon growth hormone they all come under protein hormones whereas estrogen and progesterone come under steroid hormones and iodine hormones like T3 T4 comes under that so last part of this class that is mechanism of hormone function this is protein hormones
So here we see steroid hormones. So protein hormones will bind to the receptor present on the membrane. Protein hormones bind to the receptors, this is a cell membrane. So this is the ovary cell membrane. So FSH is a hormone binds with a receptor molecule. So FSH binds with receptor of protein present on the cell membrane. This hormone direct agi ovary olagade barala. Cell membrane mele enirutte, ovary cell membrane mele receptors irutte, all bandu bind agutte. Then bind ad mele it releases secondary messengers like cyclic AMP and calcium. So these brings biochemical changes that brings physiological changes in an organ. Protein once the steroid hormones in agate, this is a cell membrane. Uterus cell membrane, this is a progesterone hormone, this nucleus, the receptors are present inside the nucleus or inside the cell. So this a progesterone hormone is a receptor that alter the function of DNA. It is a DNA or genetic material that produces mRNA, that produces proteins. These proteins bring changes, physiological changes in an organ. ನೋಡಿ ಎರಡು ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನು ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನು ಸೆಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತ ರೆಸೆಪ್ಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಜೊತೆ ಬೈಂಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಮೆಸೆಂಜರ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಲೈಕ್ ಸೈಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಎಂಪಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಶಿಯಂ ದೀಸ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಮೆಸೆಂಜರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಬಯೋಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ದಟ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫಿಸಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಸ್ಟಿರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಸ್ಟಿರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್ ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬೈಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ರೆಸೆಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾ ಸೆಲ್ಯುಲರ್ ರೆಸೆಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇವಕ್ಕೆ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಬೌಂಡ್ ರೆಸೆಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ ಇದು ಇಂಟ್ರಾ ಸೆಲ್ಯುಲರ್ ರೆಸೆಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ Once they bind with receptors, they changes the function of genome. That changes results in physiological functions of the organ. That's the main difference between protein hormone function and steroid hormone function. So we'll see now some slides related to this. See, endocrine system. So we have hypothalamus, pituitary gland, pineal gland, thymus, thyroid and parathyroid, pancreas, adrenal, ovary and testicle. Placenta also acts as endocrine gland by producing hormones during pregnancy. So this all we'll discuss in detail in your regular classes. Okay, so the next, this is a diagrammatic representation of pituitary and its relationship with hypothalamus. So anterior and posterior. So we can see portal circulation between the hypothalamus and anterior pituitary gland. So this is pineal gland which secretes melatonin responsible for sleep and wake cycle in an organism. Thyroid gland, two lobes are there which are joined with the isthmus. Behind the thyroid gland, we see parathyroid glands also, four lobes of parathyroid gland. So this is the image of thyroid and parathyroid gland. So thymus, I forgot to tell you thymus. This thymus, which is present between the heart and aorta, responsible for immune, it develops our immune system. This thymus gland produces a hormone called thymosin. ಈ ಥೈಮೋಸಿನ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಇಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟಿ ಲಿಂಫೋಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಟಿ ಲಿಂಫೋಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಥೈಮಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಇಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಥೈಮಸ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಡಿಜೆನರೇಟಿಂಗ್, ಅದು ಸೈಜ್ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇನ್ ಓಲ್ಡರ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸ್ ದ ಇಮ್ಯೂನ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೀಕ್. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಥೈಮಸ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ದೊಡ್ಡವರಾದಾಗೇನೆ ಥೈಮಸ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಶ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಡಿಜೆನರೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಮೇನ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಥೈಮಸ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಥೈಮೋಸಿನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಇಮ್ಯೂನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಡ್ರಿನಲ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ಅಡ್ರಿನಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಡುಲಾ. ದೀಸ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಬೌವ್ ದ ಕಿಡ್ನಿ, ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಯರ್ ಲಿವರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯೋರ್. So the hormones we discussed already. So this is pair of testes in male which produces hormone called testosterone, whereas ovary in female which produces estrogen and progesterone. So hormones other than endocrine gland released by heart is HCL natriuretic factor which decreases blood pressure, kidney erythropoietin which helps in formation of RBC, and we see gastrin secreting cholecystokinin and gastric inhibitory peptide. So hormonal function, mechanism of hormonal function action, we can see here protein hormone FSH binds to receptor present on the cell membrane that brings release of secondary messengers like cyclic AMP and calcium that is responsible for physiological response in that organ. This is mechanism of action of protein hormones. This is steroid hormones mechanism. Hormones will enter into the organ and it binds with the intracellular receptors or nuclear receptors. That receptors alter the function of genome that brings physiological responses like tissue growth and differentiation in that organ. So that completes the today's class. Understood. So any so thank you one and all.